one day when I was taking bath, I was applying soap. So there was a moment I realized the one who is applying the soap and to whom is it is getting applied, both are somewhere different, but both are one. But there is a thing that if there was another moment I was taking a shower and I feel that why I am not getting wet, like something is getting wet, but why I am not getting wet? This happened if I identify myself that I am Ravi. I am standing in this bathroom and I said everything around. Then I am the person who is getting the soap or getting the bath. But when I think, when I feel that I just looking at this moment like this, then I am the person who is doing all the activity, but not to whom I am getting, not the person who is getting wet. So how to manage this? Because this is very confusing situation for me. That who is doing the activity, no, who's to whom the activity is done.
There is nothing to be managed here. What you're talking of is a thought. If you want to keep thinking like this, you can keep repeating this thought. To witness the bath is to take the bath fully and be totally clean. In the bathroom, if you are thinking like this, then you will come out with shampoo on your head. Witnessing does not mean that one thinks that he is witnessing. Witnessing means that while taking a bath, just take the bath and don't think of this and that. That is witnessing. Otherwise, you can keep repeating this thought. If that is your definition of witnessing, that I am not getting wet, conceptually, whatever you are saying is not misplaced. Yes, of course. And that is also the way conventionally it has been put, that the witness is the one who cannot be wetted by water. And we all know what Krishna has said in the Gita about the Atman, right? What is it? The fire cannot burn it. The weapons cannot pierce it. So what you are saying is in that league. It belongs to that kind of literature, which is all very right. But what Krishna is saying is not a product of thought. What you are saying is a thought that you are having in the bathroom. So even though the words appear similar, yet their genesis is very different.
When I sometimes put witnessing like this, when I sometimes used to touch my skull like this, I feel that from a cell how this thing can form, that this skin, this voice, this everything is from one single cell, it transformed into such a big thing. And if I look closely, if I close my eyes, I will see there is a skull, there are eyeballs, there is lungs, everything, but everything are working together. So how can I know that thing that is working together, the person who is speaking this? Because cell, everything
this
is
a useful inquiry. It's useful inquiry that science can very easily answer. Everything that you can ask using thought is something that science can answer. So do not take it as something metaphysical. You are asking about the body, how one cell multiplies into the entire organism. Science is equipped to answer these questions. They properly belong only to science. This may sound a little strange, but I reiterate. Any question that emerges as a thought properly belongs only to science. It does not belong to spirituality. Which means that actually no question really belongs to spirituality.
Then sir, how we can differentiate between whether I am really experiencing it or it is just a thought?
No, every experience is accompanied by a thought. So experience and thought are much the same. You see, there is an internal activity. The moment you call it an experience, you have verbalized it. Don't you say, this is happening to me? That is what you name as an experience. And this verbalization is a thought. So experience and thought, they go together. You must figure this out. Is there experience without enunciation of the experience? In fact, one day I asked, is there experience without language? Is that experience the same as the one that you have with language?
So one day I was sleeping and the room is totally dark. So the first time I cannot see my hands and my face. And after sleeping on the bed, I realized that I don't have any boundaries. But that's not a thought. It's not that, because for the first time I cannot feel my body. It was like that either the darkness is everything. So that I'm asking, that whether it was experience, because for me
it's just an experience.
It was thought.
Obviously it is a thought and an experience. A little while later you would have passed into sleep. Were you still feeling unlimited in sleep? Were you feeling even limited? Neither limited nor unlimited. What you call as limitation is a thought. What you call as being limitless is also a thought. Non-duality is not an opposite of duality. All that you see around, all that you can think of, is all dualistic thought. So whenever you will come up with something that you experienced or thought of, it is all much the same.